So now that it's been a couple years since Lenovo released the Tab M10 HD second generation, I thought it would be a good time to see if this tablet is worth it in 2022. If you have other tablets you'd like to see on the channel, let me know down in the comments below. Or if you currently have this tablet, I'm curious to see how yours is holding up so far. If you're not familiar with this tablet, it's got a very similar build quality to the Galaxy Tab A7 from Samsung, but there are a few differences when it comes to the specs. It's considered an entry-level tablet, weighs in at 420 grams, so just under 1 pound, and it's just over 8 millimeters thick, so fairly lightweight and pretty thin for a budget tablet. You've got a 10.1 inch 1280 by 800 resolution, IPS display, 400 nits brightness, so plenty bright enough for indoor use. You also get 1080p resolution on YouTube and only SD playback on Netflix. So pretty standard stuff here for a budget device. Not gonna be the highest resolution tablet out there, but considering the cost is about $150 in the United States at least, that's sort of what's to be expected. I know in my testing, watching YouTube videos or movies on Netflix actually looks better than you would think. As far as the software goes, you swipe left on the home screen, you're gonna get the Google Entertainment space, which is gonna suggest content to watch, games to play, books to read, and also music to listen to. There's also features on this like Google Kidspace, which I know some parents might be looking for. And while this isn't gonna be the fastest tablet out there, you can still connect a keyboard and mouse to get things typed out a little faster or use the split screen to multitask a little better. Battery life on this one is average compared to most tablets I've tested. It lasted 6 hours in my battery drain test at full screen brightness, so you shouldn't have any problems getting through a whole day of normal use, like watching videos, reading, browsing online, playing a few games, especially on a lower screen brightness. Then it takes less than 3 hours to charge back up, which is about on par with other tablets in this category. Now, if you like tablets, phones, and other tech, consider hitting that subscribe button. I try to cover as much on the channel as possible, and I'll be posting more videos this year than ever before. You're gonna get pretty low results on Geekbench scores as expected. We're talking 157 on single core scores, 965 on a multi-core score, 4 gigabytes of RAM. The version I have here is 64 gigabytes of storage, but it also can take a micro SD card up to 256 gigabytes. So really not bad for a budget tablet, especially for this price. It is gonna struggle with some more intense games though. I know on Call of Duty Mobile, it was a little choppy, especially when there's lots of action going on in one area, but other games played fine like PUBG Mobile. It also struggled a little bit with Asphalt 9. Just keep in mind that this tablet is gonna be good for light gaming on lower settings. It also has 2.4 and 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi, Bluetooth 5.0, GPS, face unlock. This one even has a headphone jack, which you're seeing less and less of these days. Plus it has Dolby Atmos, which makes the speakers sound a lot better. Here's a quick sound test, just so you can see what they sound like. Definitely not gonna be the loudest out there, but just keep in mind, this is a budget device. The 8-megapixel rear and 5-megapixel front-facing cameras are not gonna be the best out there. Again, sort of in line with this price of tablet. I mean, it would probably work if you had to do a Zoom meeting, as long as you have good lighting and you're not able to use your cell phone, then this may work for you. I know from my testing, tablets in this price range aren't really that good at taking photos, especially in lower light situations, but I always like to give samples of each, just for those of you that are curious or just to give you an idea of what to expect. Now, when this one first came out, it had Android 10. Luckily, it's been updated to Android 11. Unfortunately, that might be the last update for this device, at least from what I've seen online. I don't think it's getting any more updates after this year. So for that reason alone, it's kind of hard for me to recommend this tablet over some newer tablets that have come out recently, like the Nokia T20, or even the Galaxy Tab A7 or A8 that's getting ready to be released in the United States. I've also got another Lenovo tablet I'm going to be showing next week that sounds like it's the newer version of this tablet. So if you're thinking about buying this tablet in 2022, you may want to wait at least 1 week so you can see the other tablet that I'm talking about. That's going to be very similar to this one. Now, obviously, it's going to depend on what you're going to be using this tablet for, but it just seems like there's some better options out there and newer tablets that's going to be supported longer. So obviously, there's going to be a lot of things to consider when buying this tablet, especially in 2022.
So if you've made it this far into the video, you may want to say thanks by subscribing, and don't forget to give a thumbs up if this video was helpful. This is Brian from Fishbee Productions. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.